Hello and welcome to the Matrixers. For the new ones among you, we are Shiva and Jonathan. We are consciousness researchers, YouTubers and bloggers and deal with the spiritual topics related to the Matrix. The pineal gland, astral travel, lucid dreaming, UFOs and aliens and of course spiritual dissociation. Our master technique, with which we have gained most of our knowledge and experience. Yes, in today's video. This is a phenomenon that one or the other has certainly experienced before, but could not put it in order. It's about... Yes, it's about dilated agitation and exiled agitation. For those of you like me who don't know what that means, these are delayed updates to or from other realities. Yes, as you know, through our videos, we clearly believe that there are multidimensional realities. Realities that are very similar to our reality that we know from everyday life. Variations and as based on the man's world theory. And these versions are parallel realities. Alternative realities are also called. Let's visit at night in our dreams. And in that regard, so at night we go into one of these alternate realities, and there are thousands of them. And then experience there what the alternative version of ourselves is experiencing. Yes, and how does it work? Our consciousness travels at night and just plugs into the alternate reality self. Of course, this also works the other way around. We don't always notice that, but also the alternatives themselves in the alternative realities, when they can go to bed and sleep, ducking onto our consciousness, i.e. connecting to their consciousness. After all, we are connected, all to one another, in particular our alternative realities, and of course we can also experience our everyday reality in this way. And the same thing happens at night. We go on journeys with our consciousness and connect to the alternative selves and can experience what they experience in their everyday life. Yes, you may know that from computer games, role-playing. Yes, exactly. Well, here goes a path and meets a trader. And the dealer tells you, yes, I have something to tell you, and then you suddenly get a choice of how you can deal with the dealer right now. For example, you can say yes. I'll give you 100 gold coins if you tell me where the bad Frederick's castle is. Or you threaten it with a sword and say if you don't say where Friedrichsburg is, then I'll lay you down. Right around. Or you can make it up, friend, and say, come on, let's have a drink and chat a little. So you have three options on how to deal with this trader. And depending on how you decide, a new reality opens up. A new line of development, so to speak. And that's how you can imagine it with the alternative realities. For example, if you're thinking, back in the past, I wouldn't have taken that stupid job. Yes, then my CV looks much better now. Yes, even with very simple things. We thought about moving to Heidelberg or to the Untersberg. A version of us is in Heidelberg now, something like that. Correct. For the subconscious, every reality is equally existent. You, however, choose a direction, a path, when you come to a crossroads that goes left, right, and straight ahead. Are you dealing with three realities and depending on how you decide, reality will then also open up. And so, alternative realities do exist for us as well. Of course, not necessarily in consciousness. Let's think there is always only one reality because we only perceive one reality. But from the perspective of the subconscious, it's like there are multiple realities. The subconscious registers all realities equally and treats them accordingly.
behandelt sie auch dementsprechend. Und das
and that is reflected in our dreams. But there's
aber
a problem.
Es gibt da ein Problem.
Ja.
Yes, which sometimes comes up, and some of you may know this.
Ja,
yes, what is an update? Yes, we call an update the feeding of memories that belong to the respective reality.
Die der jeweiligen Realität zugehörig sind.
As an example, you dream
du träumst nachts,
at night that you live in a different apartment and you look around and then think I don't even live here. I have a completely different apartment.
Hier lebe ich doch gar nicht. Ich habe doch eine ganz andere Wohnung.
Das that can't even be my apartment.
Sein.
And in that moment, suddenly the update comes in. That is, the memory update from the reality you are in right now.
Von der Realität, in der du dich gerade befindest.
And this update suddenly said, yes, you moved last week, don't you remember?
Erinnerst du dich denn gar nicht? Ne, so
according to the motto, so little, so easy comes the memories. You moved last week, so residency in a new apartment. This is an update. The update always justifies the events, the circumstances, the situations within the reality you are in right now. This is an update. So the update, it may be objective. You live in the new apartment and have been since such and such a time. And the mind disguises that and then camouflages it and says, oh, that was last week. So according to the motto, so that you don't think you're getting the wrong updates. The updates are already objective. Only the ego does that a bit. Brightens up the situation so you don't wonder. Right. Because as soon as you get an update in your dream, for example, you moved last week, you don't need to be surprised anymore. Then everything is okay the way it is. Stay where you are now. That is correct, and that is of course a problem in order to be able to become lucid within a dream that covers. Because the update affects the reality in which you are then. And as soon as the update comes in, all the wondering, the questioning is over, and then it can no longer happen that you are moved within the dream.
Und dann kann es auch nicht mehr dazu kommen, dass du innerhalb des Träumes luzid wirst.
That's the problem with updates.
Auch wenn
even if you return from the dream, from the alternative reality to your everyday life, it's also the case that the update then comes in and says, yes, you live here and there, you are this and that, you went to bed now and then and you did this and that yesterday and still wanted that today and do that.
Du hast dieses und jenes gestern gemacht und wolltest heute noch das und das machen.
So this is an update.
Ja, und dann
yes, and then you had an experience and you had such a hidden update experience. A procrastinated and delayed appetite in this and the other reality. Correct. So that means there are different, but there is the regular update. Then the procrastinated, as you say, and covering the delay. We lay down at noon for our meditation sleep and suddenly I found myself in a different reality. I was a little pre-lucid and yes, I was wondering. I was surprised because at that moment everything was completely different than in my current reality. There were a few people that appear in this reality as well, but Jonathan wasn't there. That surprised me at first. Where is Jonathan and if Jonathan isn't there, who is here in reality? Who am I in a relationship with? Okay, then no information came in for now. In reality, I also lived with my mother and I was surprised. And somehow, slowly, the memory came in. Oh yeah, you're with so and so. And yet, okay, maybe. Then I haven't seen him for months. It must have been like that was irritating and completely alien to me. But then the information really came in with a very long delay. That has took forever. There were also more odd occurrences with more delayed updates. And yes, at some point I woke up again and I no longer knew where it was up, down, front, left, back, right. It was everything. Everything was gone. I just knew my name, but I didn't think about it at the moment. I didn't know when am I. What kind of day is it noon now or is it already morning? I was so amazed. I had to work so hard to get the update now. What time it is, whether it's really still the afternoon nap or whether it's in the morning. I was actually completely convinced that it was already the next day. Then I had to think. Then slowly Jonathan came in again. I thought, Jonathan? Yeah, Jonathan is here. So very, very sleepy. Everything clean. Also, what a day it is. I didn't even know what room I was in. I have looked. Where am I anyway? In which country am I? And then in which room am I? At some point you can go in. Oh yeah, I live at El Paradiso. Where will I live and what house will I be in? Then I would first have to line up the house again for the update and at some point when I'm in bed. And what does the room I'm in look like? It was all really very, very protracted, because I still had the information from reality, where I was just connected with my consciousness and I thought Jonathan wasn't there, I live somewhere else. And yes, that all came along and it has. Usually it takes a few seconds, 30 seconds at most for the updates to come back, but this time it took about 2 to 5 minutes for everything to really come back. I was so out of touch with reality. I still have a whole day after that I was still really upset, because somehow I see I was also in this other reality or part of my consciousness. It was somehow very irritating to really come back to this reality completely. So was fascinating. Yes, it was very exciting to experience that. So it was like that for you. You first dragged the update out of the dream right into this everyday reality, because you still thought you were in another reality, although you had already changed reality. And then the update for this reality came in with a delay. Yes. And so you experienced both phenomena at once. First in the other reality and then this reality. And it's exciting, isn't it? Yes, and exactly on the same day, with the same afternoon nap, the same phenomenon. Then I woke up and thought, yes, where am I right now? Where am I? I had no plan at all. It was already dark or it was dark. And then I was convinced that it was at night, or I concluded that very early in the morning, because I have to. Apparently I was in bed, lying in bed to sleep, and it's dark outside. So it should be early morning, like 5 o'clock maybe. So I woke up in the middle of the night. I was convinced of that at first glance, but I couldn't remember exactly when I lay down and why at all. And I didn't even know where I was. I thought, what kind of room is this? Well, where am I here? And I really had to search in my head. So luckily, we always wake up at the same time. Then we had to exchange ideas. When? When is today? What day is today? At what time? We puzzled and together we still puzzled. We weren't sure either. So our updates came so delayed. We. Right in. So for me it was simply a missing update. So the update was delayed within this reality. And you probably also know this phenomenon, that every morning or maybe in the evening when he has laid you down for a nap, you wake up and are completely screwed up. That's what it's called in everyday life, woke up so confused. That's how you would describe it. So generally in everyday life with everyday colloquial language. Yes, I often woke up in the morning full of sleep. I no longer knew where I was, who I was, or what was going on. Yes, so you could also use the dilated and the exiled update as accumulation, agitation, could also be called distributed waking up. That's nice, at least we understand that correctly. And this wasted waking up, yes, there is a reason. It's not a coincidence that you wake up in the morning or in the afternoon, but there's something behind it. There is also a reason why you wake up in a mess. And now he knows exactly why. And there you see that we really are actually multidimensional selves and actually aren't really any of those. Otherwise, all the memories would not be gone. Because we are all memories, all selves, not just this one. Because otherwise we would. If we were just a self going to look somewhere, we would have our memories, if they were fixed and would never take it from here to there and anywhere. But we are not. We are everything. And that's why we need to get updates everywhere. Because we're not just single in a single reality in a single universe. Yeah, right. And we have already seen with our mediumistic abilities that there is a wholeness of the self and we here, just as we are sitting here as Shiva and Jonathan, are, so to speak, parts of this wholeness of the self. In the spiritual scene, the whole of the self is always referred to as the higher self. You could say synonymously. And the higher or so whole self spreads out in all the alternate realities. Then it will be everywhere. A compound eye has a single facet of one eye and is able to see with all eyes at once. Like flies. Flies still have one eye. The plane has the same. I don't know how many individual facets they look at separately and then put the picture together in my eye. And that's how you can imagine it. Exactly the wholeness of the self. So this is using its alternate selves that it has placed in the realities. Yes, all of it, as if it were compound eyes.
Im Ganzen als sein Facettenauge.
And what does that do to all the selves? The selves are looking for the exit to get back not only from our 3D reality or 3D matrix. Sure, we are all looking for the exit, but in truth we are looking for the way back to our higher self. Yes, we are just looking for the way back, and that's why the higher self has exposed so many selves, because one has to find the way back into wholeness.
Correct,
that was a nice ending. Yes.
Yes,
it was. That's it again with today's video. And thank you for watching. And see you soon.
Okay,
dears, we wish you all a wonderful week and lots of love.
Tschüss.
Ciao. Thank you.